الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. إن شاء الله تعالى we're going to have our class tonight in the explanation of the book of الإمام البربهاري شرح السنة, the explanation of the creed, commentary of our senior scholar and elder Sheikh Salih bin Fawzan al-Fawzan Habibahullah. Just want to remind you, next week inshallah, the classes, they're going to be after Maghrib, because the time is going to change. But after Maghrib, now. After Maghrib, inshallah, the classes will start. قال المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى والكلام والجدال والخصومة في القدر خاصة منهي عنه عند جميع الفرق لأن القدر سر الله ونهى الرب جل تعالى الأنبياء عن الكلام في القدر ونهى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الخصومة في القدر وكرهه أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وكرهه التابعون وكرهه العلماء وأهل الورع ونهوا عن الجدال في القدر فعليك بالتسليم والإقرار والإيمان واعتقاد ما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في جملة الأشياء واسكت عما سوى ذلك. The author رحمه الله الإمام البربهاري, he said, and to speak and to argue in regards to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some people have this problem. Why is it that Allah did this? Why is it Allah created this and so on and so forth? This is not permissible. This is not permissible. Why did Allah legislate this and the like? This is not permissible to question Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in terms of His creation or in terms of His legislation and other than that. So Al-Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullah, he said, and to speak and to argue in regards to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifically is prohibited according to all the sects. According to all the sects. He said, because the decree of Allah is from His secret. It's from the secret of Allah. No one has access to it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah, the Lord, the most glorified and the exalted, He forbade all His the prophets and messengers to speak in regards to al-qadr, to speak in regards to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He forbade the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to argue in regards to the decree of Allah. And the companions also, they hated talking about it. And likewise, the tabi'un. The tabi'un are those second generation. And the people of knowledge, they disliked it. They disliked talking about the affairs of al-qadr. So he said, so you have to believe in what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought from his Lord and to submit to that. And other than that, if you don't have knowledge about anything, you be quiet and you don't delve into it. Sheikh Salih Fawzan al-Fawzan, he said, من أصول الإيمان وأركان الإيمان الإيمان بالقضاء والقدر والقضاء والقدر هو ما قضاه الله وقدره في الأزل من الحوادث التي تقع. Sheikh Salih bin Fawzan al-Fawzan, hafidhahullah ta'ala, said, from the fundamental principles of al-Iman is to believe in the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what Allah decreed before He even created the creation, as it is in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah created the heavens and earth 50,000 years. Allah wrote everything that will take place. Allah wrote everything and decreed everything that would take place 50,000 years before He created the heavens and earth. So the Shaykh, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He decreed everything that will take place. وَكُلَّمَا يَحْدُثْ فَإِنَّهُ لَمْ يَحْدُثْ اِعْتِبَاطًا أَوْ دُونَ سَابِقَةِ تَقْدِيرٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ. He said, whatever occurs, it doesn't occur just like that. Randomly. But it occurs according to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بَلِ اللَّهُ جَلَّ عَلِمَ مَا كَانَ وَمَا يَكُونَ وَمَا كَانَ فِي الْمَاضِي وَمَا يَكُونَ فِي الْمُسْتَقْبَلِ ثُمَّ كَتَبَ ذَلِكَ فِي اللَّوْحِ الْمَحْفُوظِ. He said, rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knew everything that will take place. He knew everything that would take place in the future and what would take place in the past. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote that in the preserved tablets, Lawh al-Mahfuz. وَأَوَّلُ مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ الْقَلَمُ قَالَ لَهُ أُكْتُبْ مَا هُوَ كَائِنْ إِلَى يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَجَرَى الْقَلَمُ بِمَا هُوَ كَائِنْ إِلَى يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. So the Sheikh, he said, the first thing that Allah created is the pen. The first thing Allah created is the pen. So Allah commanded the pen to write everything that will take place until the day of judgment. So the pen wrote everything that will take place until the day of the judgment. وَكَانَ خَلْقُ الْقَلَمِ سَابِقًا لِخَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بِخَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ. So the pen was created before the heaven and earth 50,000 years before that. 50,000 years. وَكَانَ عَرْشُهُ عَرْشُ اللَّهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَى عَلَى الْمَاءِ. And the throne of Allah was upon the water, was above the water. ومن هنا أشكل على العلماء للعرش مخلوق قبل القلم أو أن القلم مخلوق قبل العرش. He said that's why this issue became problematic in regards to the people of knowledge. Which one was created first, the throne of Allah or the pen of Allah? So the pen, of course. والصحيح أن العرش مخلوق قبل القلم لأنه وقت خلق الله له وأمره بالكتابة كان عرشه على الماء. The Sheikh, he said, what is correct is the throne was before that. The throne was created before the pen. The throne was created before the pen. Because the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was upon water. ولهذا يقول العلامة ابن القيم رحمه الله والناس مختلفون في القلم الذي كتب القضاء به من الدياني هل كان قبل العرش أو هو بعده قولان عند أبي العلاء الهمداني والحق أن العرش كان قبله لأنه قبل الكتابة كان دا أركاني وكتابة القلم الشريف تعقبت إيجاده من غير فرق زماني. So Imam Al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, in this lines of poetry, he mentioned that the scholars have differed into two opinions. Some of them, they said the pen was the first thing Allah created. Others, they said the al-arsh, the throne of Allah, but the throne of Allah was created before the pen. And this is what Imam Al-Qayyim mentioned here. والكلام في القدر قد سبق ولكن المراد الآن النهي عن الخوض فيه. He said the speech in regards to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we already spoke about it. But what is not permissible is to delve into it, is to argue and delve into it. This is what not permissible. والكلام والجدال والخصومة في القدر خاصة منهي عنه. عرفنا أن الإيمان بالقضاء والقدر بدرجات ركن من أركان الإيمان بالله. فمن لم يؤمن بالقضاء والقدر فليس بمؤمن لأنه جحد ركنا من أركان الإيمان. The Sheikh, he said that we have known that the decree of Allah has different levels. The decree of Allah has different levels. He said, and it is one of the pillars of Iman. It is one of the pillars of al-Iman. Because the Prophet ﷺ, when Jibreel asked him about al-Iman, he said al-Iman, that you believe in Allah, you believe in His angels, you believe in His books, you believe in the Prophet messengers, that's four. You believe in the Day of Judgment, and you believe in al-Qadr. You believe in al-Qadr, decree of Allah, good or bad. So it is from the pillars of al-Iman. So the Sheikh, he said, whoever does not believe in al-Qadr, he does not believe in the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then this person is not a believer. Why? Because he denied and rejected one of the pillars of Iman. He rejected one of the pillars of the Iman. وَكَذَلِكَ لَا يَجُزُ الْجِدَالُ فِي الْقَضَاءِ وَالْقَدَرِ لِمَاذَا يُعَدِّبُ اللَّهُ كَذَا. He said, likewise, it is not permissible to argue in regards to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why did Allah punish person and soul, and why he did not punish person and soul? We should not ask questions like that. Some people are like that, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. They ask these questions, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. لِمَاذَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ كَذَا. Why did Allah do this? This is not permissible to say. And many times, you know, people, they ask questions. And I say to them, first of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from his names, Al-Hakim. From his name is Al-Hakim. He is the all-wise, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's impossible for the all-wise to do something that is not right. I mean, if someone from the creation, who has a lot of wisdom, and he speaks wisdom, and he does things according to wisdom and the like, this person, you're gonna have a lot of respect for him and the like. What about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heaven and earth, the one who knows what's good for his creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he is the all-wise in his action, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the all-wise in his legislation. He is the all-wise in his decree, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is not permissible to say why and the like. The Shaykh, he said, وَلَا يُقَى وَلِمَا وَكَيْفَ. And we should not say why. Why is this? Why did Allah do this? And the like. فَلَا يُعْتَرَضُ عَلَى اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. We should not oppose the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَدْخُلْ فِي الْقَضَاءِ وَالْقَدَرِ بِالْجِدَالِ فَإِنَّكَ لَنْ تَصِلَ إِلَى نَتِيجَةٍ. He said, do not delve or involve yourself into an argument in regards to the decree of Allah, because you're not going to reach any result. You're not going to reach any result. The Shaykh said, فَعَلَيْكَ التَّسْلِيمُ وَالْإِيمَانِ وَلَا تَدْخُلْ فِي أَمْرٍ مِنْ أُمُورِ اللَّهِ. He said, you must submit to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you must believe and do not enter into the affairs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let Allah handle his affairs. Do not enter into the affairs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِأَنَّ هَذَا لَا يَعْلَمُهُ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Because this affair of al-qadr, no one has the reality of its knowledge except Allah. No one knows the reality of it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَن تَنْتَهِي إِلَى نَتِيجَةٍ. And you're not going to reach a result. وَلِذَلْكِ يُقَالَ الْقَدَرُ سِرُّ اللَّهِ. And that's why it is said that al-qadr, the decree, is the secret of Allah. لَا يُدْرَكُ وَلَا يُحَاطُ بِهِ أَبَدًا. No one can achieve or reach it, and no one can encompass it. No one can encompass the qadr of Allah and know the reality of it. Nobody knows that except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَا تَدْخُلْ فِيهِ بَلْ عَلَيْكَ أَن تُؤْمِنَ بِمَا جَاءَ فِي النُّصُوصِ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ وَالسُّنَّةِ. Do not involve yourself in argumentation in regards to the qadr of Allah, the decree of Allah. Rather, you should stick to الكتاب, the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَتَقِفَ عِنْدَ هَذَا. And you stop right there. You don't go beyond that. Alhamdulillah, the sunnah wal jama'ah, they have the kitab, and they have the sunnah, and they have the statement of the sahaba and the tabi'een, and that's it. We don't go beyond that. We don't delve into rhetoric, philosophy, and argumentation in regards to how and this and that. You know, a lot of people, they're into this. And this can lead to al-kufr wal-iyadu billah. When a person, wal-iyadu billah, is displeased with the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why did you take my loved one, oh Allah? Some people say that, wal-iyadu billah. And they get angry. Allah is not just, wal-iyadu billah. They say this. This is kufr. You say Allah is not just. This is a serious statement, very serious statement. So you're accusing your creator of not being just, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. So Allah السلام والعافية. And that's why it's very important to study the affairs of Tawheed. That way your aqidah is strong. It's strong. It does not get shaken up. At times of trials and tribulation, you don't get shaken up. The Shaykh, he said, وَتَتَوَجَّهُ إِلَى الْعَمَلِ الصَّالِحِ وَتَرْكُ الدُّنُوبِ وَالْمَعَاصِي. And you concentrate yourself upon doing righteous deed and staying away from sins. وَلَا تَقُلْ إِنْ كَانَ اللَّهُ قَدَّرَ لِي أَنِّي مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ سِرْتُ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ وَلَوْ مَا عَمِلْتُ شَيْئًا. He said, and don't say that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed for me to be from the inhabitants of Al-Jannah, then even if I don't do anything, وَإِنْ كَانَ اللَّهُ قَدَّرَ لِي أَنِّي مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ فَسَأَكُونُ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ فَهَذَا كَلَامٌ بَاطِلٌ. So do not use, basically, what the Shaykh is saying here, do not use the decree as an excuse. You don't use the decree of Allah as an excuse. Because this is a false. فَلَا يَجُوزُ الدُّخُولُ فِي هَذِهِ الْأُمُورِ لِأَنَّ هَذَا لَيْسَ مِنْ شَأْنِ الْعِبَادَةِ. He said, we should not get involved in these affairs because this is not from the affairs of worship. Concentrate on your ibadah, on your salat, your zakat, your fast, and other than that. هذا من شأن الله, because this is from the affairs of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. أنت من شأنك العمل, هذا هو المطلوب منك. He said, you are required to perform good deeds. This is what is required from you. أما الدخول في القضاء والقدر فهذا دخول في متاهة لا يخرج منها العبد أبدا. He said, as far as entering into this affair of القدر, the decree of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, then you going to enter into a place that has no end. You're gonna enter a place that has no end. Has no end. وقوله منهي عنه عند جميع الفرق لأن القدر سر الله عند جميع الأمم لأن القدر سر الله والسر لا يمكن الإحاطة به. And the Shaykh, he said, and Al-Qadr, it is not permissible to speak in regards to the affairs of Al-Qadr and they argue about it and the like. This is all the nations, they agree upon that. Because Al-Qadr is the secret of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The secret of Allah, no one can encompass the secret of Allah. As Allah said in the Quran, في Surah Al-Baqarah, وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ. And they will not be able to encompass his knowledge except with his will, and unless he will, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, he said, لا تدخل في شؤون الله لكن عليك بشؤون نفسك. Do not enter into the affairs of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, you should concentrate on yourself. عليك بالعمل الصالح وترك الدنوب والتوبة منها. He said, you should focus on doing righteous deed and leaving off sins and repenting. وَحَاسِبْ نَفْسَكَ مَا دُمْتَ عَلَى قَيْدِ الْحَيَاةِ. And put yourself to accountability as long as you are still living. اشتغل ونفسك أما أن تشغل نفسك بالقضاء والقدر ولماذا كان ولماذا يكون. He said, as far as busying yourself with the affairs of al-qadr, like saying, why did this happen and how did this happen and the like, he said, this is not there is no need for you to delve into this. فَهَذَا كُلُّ كَلَامٌ بَاطِلٌ. He said, all this speech is false. وَلَا قِيمَةَ لَهُ. It has no value. وَلَمَّا قَالَ الصَّحَابَةُ لِلرَّسُولِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَلَا نَتَّكِلُ عَلَى كِتَابِنَا مَا قُدِّرَ لَنَا. So when the Sahaba radiallahu alayhim, they said, when the Prophet ﷺ, he spoke about al-Qadr, that everyone in the knowledge of Allah, his name is written, either in the that he will be from the people of paradise or he will be from the people of the hellfire. It's already decreed. Now the Sahaba, they said, O Messenger of Allah, if we know that this is already decreed, then why should we do any good deed? Okay, now the Prophet ﷺ, he's going to correct them. He's going to correct them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, قال, اعملوا فكل ميسر لما خلق له. So he told them, do righteous deeds. And everyone, he's going to do the deed of what he is decreed upon. Like, okay, if a person is going to be from the people of paradise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him success to do those good deeds of the people of paradise. And in the end, inshallah, he will enter the paradise. But if the person is doing the deeds of the people of the hellfire, wa'iyadu billah, you see? So he's going to go into that path until he ends up in the hellfire, wa'iyadu billah. See? طيب. Then, فَأَنزَلَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's revealed the ayah. إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. Means that your endeavor is diverse. Your endeavor and your struggle and is diverse. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى. As for the one who gives out فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And he fears Allah. وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى. And he believes. فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make things easy for him. So you want the path of Jannah, then Allah will make that path easy for you. And then he said, وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى. As for the one who he's stingy and he does not give out فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, and he believes that he is self-sufficient. وَكَدَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى. And he had been lied. فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. So we will make that road that he chose for himself easy for him. See? طيب. فَأَنْتَ تَفْعَلُ السَّبَبُ إِمَّا فِي نَجَاتِ نَفْسِكَ وَإِمَّا فِي هَلَاكِهَا. He said, you act upon, you know, this affair either by salvaging yourself and from the hellfire, by doing the good deed, or destroying yourself by going to the hell, by going to the hellfire, either by saving yourself from the hellfire and going to Jannah, or doing the opposite of that. So basically, Ahl-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, they believe that the servant has a will. It's not that the servant is compelled to do something. Nobody compels you to commit sin. Nobody compels you not, you know, to go to the masjid. You can either go to the masjid by your own choice, or you go somewhere else. Nobody compels you, right or wrong? Yes. So now. Yes, a refutation of those qadari al-jabriyas, that those who claim that you are majbur, you are compelled to commit the sin. And this is batil, this is false. Because we have a will, we have a free will. Yes. Even though the will of Allah, you know, precedes our will. As Allah said in the Quran, وَمَا تَشَاءُنَا إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ. That the will of Allah precedes our will. The Shaykh, he said, بِأَفْعَالِكَ الَّتِي تَفْعَلُهَا بِاخْتِيَارِكَ وَإِرَادَتِكَ. He said, you do all these things with your free will. You do all these things with your free will, either good deed or bad deed. كُلُّ النَّاسِ يَغْدُو. فمعتق نفسه أو موبقها. As the Shaykh, he mentioned the hadith. The hadith of Abi Malik al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, all the people, they strive. Either they strive to save themselves or to destroy themselves. So those are who strive to save themselves from the hellfire, then Allah will make the path easy for them to Al-Jannah. And those who, al-iyadu billah, strive to destroy themselves, then that path is going to be made easy for them, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, to go to the hellfire. وَقَوْلُهُ وَنَهَى الرَّبُّ جَلَّ تَعَلَىٰ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ عَنِ الْكَلَامِ فِي الْقَدَرِ. And the statement of the author, rahimahullah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited the prophets, peace be upon them, from speaking about the affairs of al-qadr, decree. نَهَى اللَّهُ الْخَلْقَ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ وَغَيْرَهُمْ. عَنِ الْكَلَامِ فِي الْقَدَرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he prohibited the creation and the Prophet, peace be upon them, and other than them, to speak about al-qadr. وَالْأَنْبِيَاءَ مَا دُكِرَ عَنُهُمْ أَنَّهُمْ اَعْتَرَضُوا عَلَى الْقَدَرِ أَبَدًا لِأَنَّهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ عَظَمَةَ اللَّهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَى. The Shaykh Salih al-Fawzan, he said, it is known that the Prophet and Messenger, they did not have any problem or oppose the Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, they had knowledge, and they had knowledge about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his wisdom. ويستسلمون القدر أبدا ويستسلمون ويتأدبون مع الله. And the Prophet and messengers, peace be upon them, they would submit to the decree of Allah, and they will have etiquette with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولا يسألون عن الشيء ليس لهم فيه مصلحة ولا منفعة. And they will not ask about anything that doesn't have any benefit or anything like that. فالأنبياء لم يسألوا عنه وكذلك لم يسأل عنه أتباع الأنبياء قط. Likewise, the prophets and also the followers of the prophet, they did not ask anything in regards to the affairs of القدر, the decree of Allah. They didn't have a problem with that. إنما كان الأنبياء وأتباعهم يتجهون للعمل ويعنون به وما كانوا يسألون عن القضاء والقدر إلا من باب الاعتقاد والإيمان به. He said the prophets, peace be upon them, and their followers, they did not ask about the affairs of al-qadr. They did not argue about it and the like. Rather, they were focused more with doing the good deed and the like, except when it comes to the affairs of belief. When it comes to the affairs of the belief, yes, someone asks about like the levels of al-qadr or the like, and the prophets and this messenger will explain to the follower those levels of al-qadr. It's the beneficial question. Now we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all al-ilm al-nafi' wal-amal al-salih. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Someone has a question? Absolutely. Jazakallah khair. Good comment. Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah will not hold the soul accountable for something beyond its scope. So it means that this is a refutation against Al-Qadariya. This is a refutation against Al-Jabriya. I'm sorry. Al-Jabriya, those who claim and believe that the servant is compelled to commit the sin. Al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, they say, the servant has a will. He's not compelled to commit the sin. Has a will. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not hold you accountable for something beyond your scope. Now, anyone has a question? That's it? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all al-ilm al-nafi' al-amal salih. الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.